Okie dokie. This is what you wanted. Turn that key off. Y-Tech's all hooked up. Already got the micropods down there. And we got Y-Tech set up over here. We have one recall showing zero flashes. You guys see what I'm seeing there? It said zero flashes, didn't it, just a moment ago? Well, let's pull up all flashes. What happened to that zero flashes? See, that's why I do my own research. I trust me better than them sometimes. All right, pop that key in, turn that key on. All right, so here it is. PCM has the update. TCM has an update as well. Of course, I'll do that while I'm in there. Here is the calibration update. If we look at that bulletin, we can actually click this open. It'll tell us flash diagnostic and system improvements. That 06416, I already closed that laptop. All right, well, I know that I saw that number in there. I'm sure if you guys go back to that other video, the one I just did live, you'll see it for yourself. But I know that that was one of the bulletin numbers that was in there. Plus, we have that AK as our highest new calibration number. We were at AG. Here's our AK. So I'm going to come right in there. I'm going to click right on this, right in the center of it. It's going to say, hey, are you sure that this is what you want to do? I'll say yes. It's going to ask me why. I'll say I understand it. Reason why. And I'll say source information, documentation led to reflash of the component. And when they ask me for something, I say, blah, 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 blah. That's what I tell them. Because it's none of their business why I'm doing it. Don't want me to log in? You betcha. And here we are. We'll download our flash file. I'm living life on the edge today, folks. If you look up there at that battery voltage, 12.28, I shouldn't be doing it. But where this car is, if I have to move it, that means I have to move about six cars behind me in order to get this thing out. And we don't have that kind of time. So, please turn the ignition key off. Ignition key is off. Hit continue. 30 seconds left. That key out in the meantime so we don't have to hear the ding ding dings. Let's see. So Bosch. See all those? They're all Bosch. They look alike? They should. They're all Bosch. I have the case out there. That's where normally where I keep my micropod is, in that empty spot right there. So if anybody wants to know why it is that I'm gonna be going to go meet with Bosch next week, it's because of that. Because they are the innovators that I've been dealing with. Alright, so it says please wait 1 second left, but it also says please turn the key on. So I did, and then I hit continue. I'm gonna start the Chrysler flash process now. And that should go pretty quickly. The next car I'm asked to look at over here is this BMW that's been sitting for I don't know how many years, but apparently just sitting outside in some yard, hasn't run in a long time, and that same customer has the black one behind it. So those will be next on the list. You guys wanted a programming video. They're so boring. You get to just sit there and stare at a screen. I almost wish I didn't have to do any programmings at all during the day. Guess somebody made a boo-boo when they were trying to write in the mileage. That's one way to fix it. There's the mileage on this thing. No bus. Oh, that's right. I can't see it right now. I'm going to say, I think I already looked at it. I think it was 49,000. Come on, Slowpoke. There it is, 5 minutes. It's gonna turn me into a long video. I hate long videos. Don't you guys hate long videos? Mm-hmm. The other car that I just had before all that there was that Hyundai Sonata that's down there at the end. That Hyundai Sonata was a good one. That was actually one that it was setting ABS codes. And that's what the customer's complaint was that there was ABS codes. And that they had no throttle at times. Well, the reason it had no throttle was generally because the crank sensor was starting to fail. It was actually getting to the point where the car ran so poorly that it barely even ran at all. So then it would trip a throttle code. Yeah. Sometimes the customer's descriptions of what they give to people in the shop is just amazing. I had the car out there. I drove it around just one block. And by the time I got back over here again, it stalled out twice just pulling into the driveway. Come on now. Downloading physical block. Please turn the key off. 45953, by the way. Keys off. Let the suspense get to you. There it is. Turn the key on. Woohoo! Yeah, I'll tell you that Y-Tech is so buggy. They had nothing up there for voltage a moment ago. It's a good way to scare the bejesus out of somebody. Anyhow, that will have the PCM update already done. First thing I'm gonna do, turn that key all the way off. Start it up again. Make sure it runs. Great. I'm going to let that run for a minute. Get that battery voltage back up. And then I'll just do the TCM. But if I go into PCM in the meantime here, might as well do this because I don't need to have you guys along for every bit of it. But here's my current part number, the AK. And there is the most up-to-date part number. So we definitely have the update in there. And I don't know whether or not we can do it. Let's see. Where are you? Details? No. System tests? Maybe. Does it have carb readiness? I don't know. It's been so long since I actually looked in here. It's not going to be under actuators. Where is the readiness monitors? There it is. OBD2 monitors down there. Carb readiness status. Everything there should be showing not complete, which it is. What's missing? How odd. Stopped, waiting. Pass test. In progress. Is this all my fuel monitor right here? All showing that it passed? You know, curiosity is going to get the best of me here. I think that before I even do that TCM update, and just so we can close out this video, let's unplug this and plug this bad boy back in. Shall we? Of course we shall. I love doing this stuff one-handed. Alright. Okay. Plug that back in. Alright. Bosch is invented for life. Let's see what we get here. It's a shame that on camera it doesn't give you an idea of how nice the screen is. One of the things I have to say, when they did that upgrade there between the time that they went from the Encore up to this one, and I'm sure it's tablet-based on the inside there. I don't know what kind of tablet they stepped it up to, but I like it. Do the select vehicle again, do the auto ID, just to keep everything the same as what I did earlier. It's going to read that OBD Mode 9 VIN. Look at this, 11 minutes. That's like double, I think, my longest video. You guys are probably all asleep already. Let's see, latitude. Let's go right back in there again, same as I did before, enhanced OBD2. And comes. Okay. Not ready. Okay, good. So I don't know which one it said was ready. Misfire here is showing ready. Comprehensive component showing ready. I don't know what that other nonsense was. It's interesting. Well, just to verify. Check for any codes. Pending permanent, nothing. All good. All right, so I'm going to give this back over to the customer. They're going to drive it. Of course, after I do the transmission control module update. And then I'll do a follow-up on it, hopefully, as long as I'm able to. Again, this car comes from out of state, so, you know, they may just bring it over there, get the inspection done, and I never see it again. But if I can do a posted update, I will, and it'll be up on the Facebook page. All right, thanks again for watching.